Hi there, and thank you for tuning in to the JIT Company's YouTube channel, the channel for all things related to lean, just-in-time manufacturing. My name is Rob van Stekelenburg, and our mission at the JIT Company is to help you to create and sustain flow in your supply chain. Now, in this video, I'm going to demonstrate our multi-item demand profiler, or MDP for short. I don't believe there is a one-size-fits-all value stream or supply chain strategy. Your approach should probably depend upon your context, and one of the main factors to consider is the profile of your market demand. I thereby typically look at four key demand characteristics. And these are volume, meaning the quantity required by your customers, variability, meaning the amount of fluctuation in demand volumes over time, frequency, or the interval with which you need to supply your market, and lastly, urgency, by which I mean the time that your customers allow you to supply them. Now, with MDP and its companion application SDP, you will learn how to analyze these aspects in depth, and the good thing about it, you can do it with just one click. Now, I will leave a link to both applications in the description below so you can check them out. But back to our multi-item demand profiler, or MDP. Like many of you out there, I guess, I've been developing Excel workbooks and Access databases to get my head around the demand patterns of a certain company. Now, at one moment I thought, maybe I can put this experience in a more professional application and make that one available. I use this one in my client engagements, and I can tell you it saves me a ton of time. So without further ado, let's jump in and have a look at MDP. And by the way, if you like our stuff, please subscribe to our channel to not miss out on any future videos. After you download the application from our shop, you will get a zip file with the application and a short manual. Now, after you fire up the application, you will land on a work standard sheet for the tool. This standard provides a clear and visual instruction on how to use the application in a TWI-based fashion, as is the case also with our other applications. Now, I recommend to familiarize yourself with the steps, but you will notice it is quite self-explanatory. Now, to start a new demand pattern study, you will first need to put in some metadata or data about the study itself. So I prepared it somewhat for this demo. So here you enter the site or the plant, the scope of your study. This could be a product family or products from a specific process, like in this case from the finishing process. And you enter the material type. Now this could be, for instance, finished goods, like in this case, or semi-finished goods. It just will be purchase components or even MRO items for maintenance purposes. Now to the right, you can then enter some metadata about the report, like the date, the version, and the creator. But now let's go to the more interesting part, which is the data. So we click this button and go to our data entry sheet. Now in this worksheet, you can enter your order line level data that will be used for the analysis. You'll need the order line, an order line ID, the entry request first promise, and if already shipped, the actual delivery date, an item ID and item description, the quantity and its unit of measure, and the value and its currency. Now for this demo, I have a real life data set ready to be used, so I will copy this one into our data sheet. So here is our data. I will copy it and enter it into our application. And now, after this has been done, all there's left to do is to click the Run button. Now, MDP performs the demand pattern analysis on the background and then brings us to the item details sheet first. So there we are. This sheet has all the item details and statistics per item, and on the top you can see some summary data, but I won't go into too much detail here. We'll go immediately to the visual dashboards that NDP provides you with. Now, first, let's go to the volume analysis. So here, you get one of the most basic, but unfortunately also only things that are being done when analyzing demand, the so-called ABC analysis. Now here, the items are sorted based upon value, and based upon a certain split value, they are being put in the A, B, and C categories. These are also often referred to as runners, repeaters, and strangers. Now, NDP gives you this instant ABC analysis, whereby you can also change the split values here on top. So in this case, the split is 70-20-10, which you can also see here, 70-20-10 in the ABC analysis. But you can change this, for instance, to be 80-15-5, which is also something which you sometimes see. Further down below, in addition to the bar chart, the ABC bar chart, it also gives you a cumulative Pareto chart, which is very often used, and a Marimekko or Mekko variant of the chart, with a very quick summary effect of the A, B, and C items, or runners, repeaters, and strangers. Now, if you want to learn more about these techniques, I recommend that you watch our demand profiling playlist on our channel. Now, a comparable approach, but one that is sometimes proposed in lean circles only, is Glenday's sieve. Now, MDP will give you this perspective as well, instantaneously. But let's go on with the next one and add some more sophistication into our analysis. Because as I mentioned, demand pattern analysis involves also looking at variability, frequency, and urgency. So let's first look at variability and frequency then. On this sheet, you can see a summary of the whole data set. So the 12,000 order lines and almost 1,800 items in terms of their variability and their demand interval or frequency. Now on the left here, variability, you can see a summary of the variability, and you can see that about 2/3 of these items, 62%, or almost 1,100 items, could be considered to have a relatively smooth demand pattern based upon their relative standard deviation. Unfortunately, these 1,100 items only represent 23% of the volume and almost 30% of the value. So, now, to the right of this table, you can see a similar summary, but now considering the demand intervals. So this table shows that most items are required on a biweekly basis, covering 39% of volume and 45% of value. Unfortunately, we do not have anything which is required daily, which we would of course prefer, and only a few, but quite some significant volume and value that is required on a weekly basis. Now, below these two tables, MDP summarizes these two viewpoints in a table, in a matrix, a variability regularity matrix. Now, what we are looking at is, of course, to get a lot of smooth daily items. Those are the ones that we like. So, you can see that most of this company's value and volume so is in the category weekly and varying, and that they particularly have to work on increasing the order and delivery frequency to create more flow. Yeah, you can see the summary here. Most of the volume is in less than bi-weekly. Yes. Now, below this table, there is an appealing visualization which represents the top 500 items in terms of value, characterized by their variability and demand interval. This gives you a nice visual interpretation of where your value is positioned in terms of variability and frequency. Now, next one is demand volume over time. So here you see an overview of the demand pattern from a request perspective, how we promised it, and how we delivered it. And interesting, for instance, here you can see these peaks. And if you look at the dates, well, what a surprise, they're all at the end of the month. So NDP will instantly give you these patterns and create a good trigger for some good discussions. Next on is the lead time. Now on the first row, you see the requested lead time over time and its distribution. And you can see that the average requested lead time here is about 29 days. But as you can see from the graph and the box plot, it is heavily skewed to the right. So probably it's better to go with the median in this case, which is at around 7 days. Now, the next one is, how do we promise it to our customer? Now there you can see that our median is at 60 days. Now, already makes you wonder, right? Now let's go to the next one, which shows you the lead times with which we actually delivered our customer. Now this one is at 58 days. But for both, you can see we have a big variation around these values, which is not a good sign at all. Now let's confront these lead times with each other to create some insights into our delivery performance, which is our last dashboard. Now on this last sheet, our first row shows us our delivery performance against request. And as expected, this view hurts, yeah. We're at 3.1% on time versus request, with a median of 18 days late versus request, and a span of 128 days. And a stability factor of only 4% here. That is not a good value at all. Now, the next row shows you how well we are promising our customers their goods versus their request. Now, also here you can immediately deduce from the charts, this is not a good picture. Yeah. So on average, we promise the goods to be supplied 12 days later than requested. And finally, the last row shows us then how well we are delivering not against request, but against our promise. Now, hopefully, this last one gives us some hope. And visually, you can already see that this looks somewhat better. Now, still, our actual delivery versus first promise is at less than 1%. So that's a little bit too bad. But at least you can see from the span perspective that we only have 42 days of span. So again, interesting insights coming from all of these order lines and all created with just one click. So this wraps up the overview of MDP. You've seen that with the push of a button, you can create a very powerful and insightful set of dashboards. You get instant insight even with large data sets like the one in the example with 12,000 order lines. And creating these insights normally would take me hours, if not days. And now it can be done with just one click. And I can tell you that I myself am very much helped with this. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video and hope you found it useful. Please let us know in the comments below. Now, if you would like to know more about the JIT Company, please do visit our website at thejitcompany.com for more. Here you will also be able to find the application we have demonstrated in this short video, and you can find the exact link in the description below. I also recommend checking out the single item companion application, SDP, that allows you to create similar insights, but then for a single item and with far more detail even. So check out the SDP video that you will see on your screen at the end of this video. For now, thanks for watching. Please leave your comments, and I would very much appreciate if you would like and share this video and subscribe to this channel. And then I hope to see you back in one of our next videos.